looking for me, I'm probably in Metropolis. I do this for the love, so this is non-profit shit. I'm bored walking, so you can call this a monopoly. Obviously, my approach to music ain't moderate. As my macabre spins, I am the anomaly. All right.
Welcome back to another episode of the A-Flow Show podcast. Back after a week off from spring break. Hope everybody had a good spring break. We are here, episode 50, the Big 5-0. And we're going to change up things a little bit. So 50 episodes ago, I decided to start this, and I interviewed a bunch of my friends. Like, the first 10 podcasts were just interviews with my friends. If you have time, go back and listen to those. Those are great listens. My first guest ever on the A-Flow Show was my friend Brendan Fleischauer.
What up?
And he's a regular co-host of the show. He's always here. But we decided to go back and interview him again just to try to get to know him a little more.
Because I could have been lying the first time.
Because you could have been lying the first time. And really, that first interview wasn't really, like, get to know. It was just, like, asking questions about the past childhood. But anyway,
right.
Brendan Fleischauer's here. Brendan, what is up?
What's going on, bro?
Not that much. How was your spring break?
Can't complain, man. It was nice to have a week off. What about you?
It was good. It was really good.
Yeah.
College basketball, of course, always.
It's fun.
Always. And then baseball started up in 4 days, so good times to be a
sports fan.
A podcaster.
Or and a podcast. Well, both, I guess so, huh?
All right, so let's get started. We got about 40 minutes here. We'll get as much as we can get out, knock out. All right, number one, what is your full name?
Hadn't changed. It's still Brendan Keith Fleischauer.
All right, and where does Keith come from?
My dad's middle name. So that's just where Brad Keith came from.
He kept it?
Yeah.
Okay. And any nicknames as a child?
Flesh.
That's Flesh. That's
a, well, I mean, as a child, I guess not really, but, you know, in high school, Flesh was kind of the thing.
Mm-hmm.
Coach Maddox.
Coach Maddox. Now, do you still like that nickname?
Yeah, no, I don't mind it, dude. A lot of people know me by that, so
by
I'm
Flesh.
Cool with it, dude.
Okay.
It's a lot easier to say than Fleischauer.
It is. It is. What was your favorite toy as a child?
Favorite toy as a child? Dude, I was big on the Hot Wheels. Like, when I was little, I would get, like, the tracks and shit that had, like, the flips and stuff in them, and I would play with those a lot, but that's the only thing that really sticks out in my mind when I think of that.
Where did you grow up? I guess here in Lubbock, right?
Yeah.
And anywhere else? Did you move anywhere? Would you move anywhere? Would you ever move anywhere?
Now, I mean, not right now, obviously, but, like, in the future, yeah. Because, okay. I mean, I don't want to just experience Lubbock my whole life, dude. Like, there's a lot out there.
Well, you're going to Norway, right?
Yeah, well, this summer.
Okay,
yeah.
That should be a fun time, right?
That'd be cool as shit, dude.
Okay, next question. If you could go back to the first day of high school, what advice would you give yourself?
Probably to try, dude.
To try.
Yeah, because, like, I mean, maybe not necessarily freshman year, but I do, or in sophomore year, but I do know that, like, junior and senior year, like, taking those dual credit classes and stuff would have actually paid off.
Like, they would have foreign language.
Yeah, for sure. So that probably just knowing more about that it actually matters.
Mm-hmm. I mean, look at our other friend, Jake Brace, already about to graduate.
Got a master's degree in like a year or something, dude.
Because he did those dual credits. Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, that's good advice. What is the most recent thing you've learned?
Oh, man.
And it could be anything. Not school, but just
anything.
Anything
in general? Yeah. I've learned that white wine's not too bad.
You like that?
This is not bad, dude. Yeah.
What is that called for the listeners?
White Zinfandel. That's what it... Is that what it looks like? Right. Beringer, maybe.
Yeah.
I don't know, dude. It was just in my fridge. I grabbed it, and it's not bad. So, I guess that's the most recent thing I've learned.
Okay. All right, here we go. Here's a good one. What was the scariest moment in your life?
It ended up not being real, but I was scared, pretty scared, dude. So my mom and aunt. Okay, me, Rowdy, my cousin Rowdy, and my brother and stuff were all over at my house. You know, like, we were younger playing and stuff. Like, I was probably like 12 or 13 maybe, and I kept getting, like, prank calls all night and stuff, and so I had no idea, but my mom and aunt had decided to prank us all, and so she comes through and, like, hits the door, so, like, I'm trying to figure out the best way to tell this chronologically. Like, okay, so I'm getting these prank calls, and then, like, it's starting to, like, get kind of weird and stuff, and so my aunt calls my mom and says, well, I'll go check around and see, like, if anyone's, you know, like, around y'all's house, you know, and stuff, and so... And then all of a sudden we hear like a big bang on the door. Like, it's not like a knock, it's like a bang. Uh-huh. And so it wasn't. And then we open the door. My aunt falls through, swear to God, dude, a knife in her back with like blood around it and stuff. And so it's like, what the hell? Like, what the hell is that? But then long story short, after freaking out for about 2 or 3 minutes, my rowdy found out that it was just ketchup and then a knife stabbed into a piece of cardboard. It was scary, though, dude. Like, when you think of seeing someone murdered, that's pretty scary.
Okay.
I didn't tell that story very well, but...
It's all right. It's all right. We're learning.
My first podcast.
It's your first podcast. How many would you say you've been on?
Probably 35 to 40 out of the 50 for sure.
Okay.
Maybe upwards of 40.
Yeah. All right. So let's say, next question. What it was this... Okay, no. I did that one. What would you change about yourself? One thing you would change about yourself.
I don't know. Is it... Am I supposed to answer this? Is this a trick question?
No.
No, I'm kidding. Maybe... change about myself.
I mean, if you're happy with yourself.
I mean, I am, but there's always something you can touch up, dude, I would say. Maybe if my... like, I know I'm not done with my beard yet here, but maybe if my beard would grow in evenly, or my hair while my face would grow in evenly right now, that'd be cool. Because it looks pretty stupid when it comes in.
Do you
dude.
Want a full beard, or
not really? Are you going it's just like right here it grows up, like up this side, and then this side it's struggling.
Okay, so the beard, okay.
Not even a beard, but just like my fuzz on my face, all if right. it was even.
Okay. What is your go-to karaoke song?
Oh, I can't say that I have one really, dude. I don't know. If I had to pick a song, I have no idea, dude. Pass. Man. I don't know. I would panic in that situation.
Really? That's
I wouldn't go karaoke anyways, I don't think.
You'd be too embarrassed.
Not what's the song? What's the obvious one that you would do?
Don't Stop Believing or okay. something about Queen of Bohemian Rhapsody or something like that.
I'll roll with Don't Stop Believing, dude.
Okay.
I know I do know all those words, so.
All right. When did you find out about Santa?
I was pretty young, dude, but I was still devastated. It was probably like, or is 10 young, or is that old for finding out?
I don't know.
I think I was a little younger than that. I don't know, dude. I was 9 or 10 or something, but I was devastated.
Who told you? Your mom?
My dad.
Your dad?
Yeah, and my mom, too. It kind of just slowly happened. Like, I mean, I just started to doubt it one year, and then by the end of the year, both of them had told me.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's tough. That was a tough one.
Did they tell you, like, not to tell your brother or anything like that?
Well... No, because he wasn't alive yet.
Oh, okay.
But when when he was growing up, my mom didn't want him to believe in it.
Oh, really?
Yeah, because she just didn't want him to be let down. I guess maybe I was like a bitch about it or something. She was like, I don't want him to act like this.
You were scarred for life.
They never cared if I, you know, told him that he wasn't real. So,
what is your go-to fast food order?
Go-to fast food order? Probably just a number one anywhere.
Anywhere with cheese or no cheese?
No cheese, dude. No cheese.
Yes, you're not a big cheese guy.
No cheese. Lately, at least. Yeah, no.
Just a number one anywhere.
Number one anywhere. Maybe, you know, a couple of McChicken, small fry, and a large unsweet tea. That's go-to right there,
that's
too.
Go-to right there. Have you ever been arrested?
I haven't, dude.
No.
It's good news. Let's not jinx myself. I'm not going to look.
What did you do on your 21st birthday?
Oh, God.
What day did
it
fall on?
You know what, dude? It's a complete blur.
Really?
And I'm trying to think back to this day. You know, I have no idea what day it fell on. I want to say it was on the weekend. But, you know what? I think it was actually in the week sometime because we had that July 4th party at my house. Remember? Mm-hmm. Were you there?
Yeah.
I feel like you were there, yeah. So, I guess just that party was kind of the thing. Like, I don't know if I necessarily did anything...
On your birthday.
You know what? No, I did go grab a six-pack at, like, noon on my birthday that day.
Do you remember what it was?
It was a Bud Light Lime six-pack. I remember BLM. That now.
Okay. Who do you owe...
Long day, dude. That was a long day of drinking.
Was it?
Yeah.
Who do you owe an apology to?
Who do I owe an apology to? Oh, God, dude. These are tough. I should have studied these. Who do I owe an apology to... Let's come back to that one, because I know there's someone out there, and I'll figure it out.
All right, let's see. Next one. What do you wish you invented? It's the one thing
what
you
What do wish I wish I invented?
Could have been anything.
An iPhone.
An iPhone.
I don't want to take away from Steve Jobs or anything, but these things took over, dude. And these are badass. Mm-hmm. I think they're badass. Some people don't like them, but an iPhone. Or something like Macs or something like technological would be cool.
Who would you take a bullet for?
Probably, like, all my friends and family, dude. Like, everyone in the crew, everyone in my family and stuff. Not anyone in particular, but it's a lot of people.
Okay. Let's see. Who's the one person you would like to punch in the face?
Golden Tate from the Golden Tate. Well, he's a Lion now, which makes me hate him also against he's a Lion. He's but a Golden State. Golden State. Whatever his name. Golden Tate, because I hate that dude.
Okay. What city do you hate the most?
Either, like, I don't have to have been there, right?
No,
I mean, I guess a place that I hate that I've been, yeah, I don't even know about that, but I do know that I hate, like, Chicago.
Okay, just because?
Well.
The Bears. The Bears.
I don't like them. I don't like, screw it, dude, I don't like Minnesota, Detroit, or Chicago.
Or San Francisco.
Oh my God, San Francisco, I hate them too, man. God. Or not them, but that play, I don't know.
Alright, this should be a good one, and I hope I get a good story out of this one.
Alright.
What is the craziest thing your Uncle Tim has done?
Oh my God.
Think about that.
Dude, that's tough, man. Most recently, maybe just like, you were there, I feel like, dude. I feel like that night we went to the concert, he was pretty wild that day, just throughout the day and stuff. I know, like, it was tough. It was a blur for me, too, but just the way he was acting at the end of the night where he was so just like, fuck it with Robbie and stuff, dude. Like, she was, like, bawling and shit. Dude. He was just like, I don't give a shit. He's funny, man.
My favorite part from that weekend was when we stopped by Buddy Holly's gravesite. So we're in the limo. We drive to Buddy Holly's gravesite. Buddy Holly, real famous here in Lubbock. And Brad gets a beer and dumps four of it out. Like, you know how you, for my dead homies or something, gives them some beer.
That was hilarious, dude.
Tim's funny, man. That's cool. Alrighty. Where's the one place you would want to have sex?
Oh. The one place I would... I don't know about if, like, a public place would be a great idea.
It could be anywhere, the White House, a church.
Oh, so you're talking, okay.
A stadium, where's the one place?
Is it weird if I wanted to have sex at Lambeau Field?
No.
That's probably...
On the 50-yard line?
Maybe on the 50-yard line, dude. Maybe, yeah.
In the snow.
Probably not. That'd be tough. Okay. I might have to go there down in summer.
Are you hardcore? I mean, how big of a fan are you, man?
I'm a pretty big fan, so I might do that in December.
Okay.
That's a good place, actually, dude.
What has been the best day of your life?
Best day of my life? God, dude, I hate to keep... This is so gay of me to say. I hate to keep saying, but when Green Bay won the Super Bowl a couple years ago, dude, it's a great day.
Yeah, that's...
That's an awesome day, dude, when you're, like, a big fan of someone. But other than, like, sports-related, best day of my life... That's a tough one, dude. There's been, like, a bunch of good days. I would hope I've had a few good days out of... As many I've been around. I don't know, dude. I'll roll with the Green Bay right now.
Green Bay winning the Super Bowl.
Yeah, because that was cool as shit. But something will probably pop up.
Okay, so you got a fire. There's a fire at your house. You know, hopefully not.
Right.
For the sake of the questions, fire at your house. You have time to run in and save one thing. What would you save?
Probably my dog, dude. Sadie? My dog's my homie. Yeah, Sadie's cool. I would definitely try to get her.
Okay, yeah, good answer there. Can't ever go wrong.
Right.
Best concert? And best sporting event you've ever been to?
Best concert is definitely Avenged Sevenfold, dude, where they came with Buck Cherry and Papa Roach. Dude, that was crazy. And then definitely best sporting event was this past...
The Cowboy Packer game,
dude, that we went to.
You guys guys were having a really good time, man.
Dude, I was drunk as shit having a ball, dude. That was so fun, yeah, for sure.
Okay. Who is the one person that will make you the most nervous to meet? Dead or alive.
Dead or alive. Most nervous to meet. I mean, I guess the president would make anyone nervous, no matter who it is, but that's kind of a corny answer, I feel like. I'll roll with the president right now. Or maybe, like, a babe, dude. Like, I would hope I wouldn't be, like, a nervous wreck in front of, like, a Megan Fox or something, but maybe someone like that.
Well, didn't you touch Jenna Jameson's hand?
I did, dude. I did.
Was that nervous or no?
Nah, because I was trying to... She was walking by. I didn't have to, like, have a conversation with her, so, like, there was nothing to be nervous about, like... But, like, having a conversation with, like a supermodel would be kind of... That'd be awesome, but... Make it maybe a little
nervous.
Who's
your number one right now, if you had
to pick? Hottest chick out right now?
Yes.
Oh, there's so many, dude. There's so many. Maybe, like... Dude, Melanie Iglesias, man. She is a... Oh, my goodness gracious. I don't know if she's number one, but she's the one who came to my head when you said that.
Okay, man,
have you not seen her?
I have not. I'm about
dude,
to
you're about to be blown away, I think.
How do you spell Melanie? Like that? N-I-E?
There she is. Yeah, you're about to have your mind blown probably, dude.
Okay.
Look at this one right there.
Okay.
But you know how, I mean, like, they're still, like, you would probably roll with, like, a blonde chick.
I probably would. Kate Upton probably would.
Kate Upton's awesome.
Oh, that's kind of what I like, I guess.
Yeah. Oh, but God, dude, she's awesome.
Where is she from? Was she an actress or what?
I think she's Enrique Iglesias'
Don't say daughter.
Sister.
Okay.
No.
I'm about to be like, God, no. God damn it.
I hope that's not his daughter.
Okay, yeah, I mean, that's...
But she passes the number one test, I think. Like, she has all the qualities of... that physically you would want, I think, you know what I mean?
What is the craziest or weirdest thing you've done for money?
Oh, I'm trying to think back to what I said the first time you asked me this, because, craziest thing I've done for money? I mean, I don't know necessarily, like, if this is crazy or not, but I have, like, me and my cousin would, like, literally go door to door knocking, asking if anyone needed their yard mowed or something. That's not crazy, but I mean, that's kind of like a desperate way of wanting money.
Okay.
That's all I can think of right now.
What's the biggest bar tab you picked up?
Oh, God, dude. Does the strip club count? No, I'm kidding, dude. No, that doesn't count, because that's not a bar tab. That was just stupidity. A bar tab? I picked up a few. Not like, you know, where everyone goes out and I'm just like, oh, let's go. Like, I got it all, but like, at a bar, I've probably spent, like, at least $50 before. Like, on a good, like a night where I'm out to have a ball.
Yeah. Wow.
Like, I would say 50 is probably maybe the most I've blown, you know, like, at one place for sure.
You ever dipped on a tab before?
No.
No?
No, I believe in karma, dude. So, like, if you do something like that, you're gonna get, something's coming your way.
Okay.
That's what I think. I don't know.
What is the one thing a woman should never do?
Oh, there's a lot, dude. Smoke a cigarette.
Okay, I agree there. God, I agree, dude. That is a very, very, very big turnoff.
It's big time gross, dude. Cigarette, and I smell them at campus, dude, and it's just gross, man. But other than that, let's see. One thing a woman should never do. I guess that's all I can think of, dude, is a cigarette, because that's not a good thing at all. But, a bunch that are turnoffs for me, dude. I can't think of one in particular besides a cigarette right now.
It's okay. Yeah. It's a good answer. Good answer. Yeah. Next one. If you could lock up one person for the rest of their life, who would it be?
Golden Tate.
Golden Tate. You hate
No,
this
I'm
kid.
Kidding, dude. That's a joke. Not Golden Tate. Jay Cutler. No, that's messed up. I'm just kidding. None of them. They're just out
not
doing
Casey
their,
Anthony.
They're
not
just
George
doing their
Zimmerman.
Job, dude. Okay, you know what? You're right. Casey Anthony, get her bitch ass in jail. That's good, dude. No, I'm kidding about the athletes. They're just doing their job, but definitely get Casey Anthony's a bitch, dude.
Okay. If you had to close one restaurant chain forever, what would it be?
Restaurant chain. It's a tough one. There's a few that I don't like at all that I never go to. Like, is Carl's Jr. still going?
Not here in Lubbock, but it's going.
Still,
yeah.
I guess maybe that, just because that's always, anytime I've ever eaten there, it's just messed me up, dude. Like, I didn't eat there a lot. I remember it was here when I was younger, and so I just remember having bad experiences with it.
Okay, even though Kate Upton's a spokeswoman for that.
Is she really?
She's had those commercials.
Well, I mean, she could be a spokesperson for a lot of things, I'm sure, looking the way she does. So.
Yeah.
She's not going to lose any employment, I wouldn't assume.
Okay. Let's see. What is the most inspiring movie you've ever seen?
I always thought Remember the Titans was kick-ass, dude. That movie was kick-ass. I didn't even know you were going to ask me that question, and that movie just came to my mind right away, so probably that one, dude.
You remember a quote from that movie?
Left side.
Strong side, dude. Oh,
that movie is, that's a good movie.
Yeah,
man.
Left side, strong side.
That's one of the best parts of that movie, too, is when they do that. Yeah. They all hate each other until that,
and
seems
then
like.
That's when they kind of just become a team and. Yeah, that's a good movie. Okay, what is the greatest physical pain you felt?
Physical pain. Man, there's been... I guess I haven't really been too injured before. Like, you know, my thumb... This is, like, kind of bitchy, you know, like, because it's a thumb, but that really hurt when that happened, dude, because, like, basically, I snapped my thumb, the tip of my thumb, dude, and so that was tough, dude. That hurt like hell, and, you know, my foot injuries, I broke my foot once, and that... hurt, but I think the thumbs hurt the worst, dude. Maybe when I, or no, that didn't even hurt when I sliced my thumb open. That was just like, you know, when you cut yourself with something real sharp, you hardly feel it. So yeah, probably just my thumb, dude.
Okay. How did you heard it? I mean, was it soccer related?
Yeah, do you not remember? You don't remember? Okay, Eric missed a PK against, I want to say it was a team where, you know, it was like a 2-1 loss or like a 1-1 tie or something where we could have, but I mean, that's irrelevant now, but I went in sliding for it after, you know, when you miss a PK, you just want to get to the ball first, you know what I'm saying? So I went in sliding, just had my hand behind my back full and just landed on it, and I came out right away. I never had to ever get out of a game because of like a hand, you know. Yeah. You would think like a foot injury or something, like, yeah, you can't play on, but it hurt, dude. They put a big old cast on my hand for like a month or so.
If you could be on any TV show in history, what would it be?
Can I go with Lunchbox and say Real World?
Yeah, I want to be on
Real
World.
I think that would be fun, dude. Real World would definitely be cool. I remember back in the day, not so much now, but I remember back in the day, I paid a lot of attention to every season. Yeah. And stuff. And, like, I remember, like, Austin's season.
Austin might have been the best season.
That was one of the best ones ever. I think. Yeah. Do you remember when that dude got popped in the face and, like, yeah, broke his
Danny,
face?
Yeah.
Danny, yeah, dude.
And Wes, Nehemiah, dude.
Maybe one of those challenge seasons would be cool, too.
The challenges are getting a little bit better.
Yeah, they're cool.
They're getting a little better. I wish they'd get more beautiful talent because we still have Johnny Bananas.
Yeah, like the same dude.
CT. I mean, get them out of here, yeah. You know? Real World, what city would you want to go?
I'm a big Las Vegas fan, dude, and I love Vegas, and so I think, like, are you saying what my favorite season would be?
No,
I would want to go to do, like, if I were to be able to go to one, like, where would I rather?
Okay, like, this season they're in San Francisco. What city
would, like, you? Oh, probably Vegas, yeah.
Vegas, okay. Yeah. Alrighty. Favorite arcade game?
The basketball, I don't know, what, like, if it has a name, just where you shoot out there, it comes right back to
the,
you.
The boss comes
back.
Like, the one where it stand still, the one that moves forward.
Yeah, that one too. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Those are fun.
Have you ever won a large amount of tickets from one of those?
I mean, I've done pretty well. I'm not trying to brag or anything, but I might hold the Chuck E. Cheese record right now. No, I'm kidding, dude. I went there for
throwing the Chuck E. Cheese.
I remember I went there, dude, for John's nephew Cassidy's birthday one time, and I did break the record. I'm not saying that record had been there, but it wasn't hard to break. So, but yeah, that game is fun, dude.
Okay, where is the worst place to be stuck waiting?
Probably a bathroom line, dude. A bathroom line, just because you have to. I haven't been in many long bathroom lines, but when you have to wait in line to go to the bathroom, that's probably one of the worst.
Like at a sporting, like a football game.
Yeah. Definitely.
Dude, mine would be like waiting in a bar, like
That's a good one too. I mean, like sit out cold or something. Yeah,
and really the payoff's not that great. It's not. You know, you wait so long and then it's just like, man.
Then you could have went to the place next door that didn't have a line.
Yeah. Alrighty. All right. If you had triplets, what would you name them?
Triplets.
And it could be all boys, all girls. It could be a mixture of. What would you name them?
All right. Brennan Jr. damn, this is tough, dude. Hold on. Obviously, I don't know if I'd really name a kid after me, but without thinking, since I have to have three of them, mm-hmm. I'll say one of them will be Brendan. Another one would be, man, these are tough, dude. I feel like a name is something you have to think, I have to take time with, dude. Okay. Brendan. Sadie. No, I'm kidding. You're not I don't know, dude. That's a tough one, man. I can see if I can think of one throughout this, but
nah, come on.
Alright. I'm gonna roll with Brendan. What goes good with Fly Shower? See, this is what I'm saying. Like, I have to think of something that goes good with my last name.
Brendan Fly Shower.
Okay, so I'm rolling with the
Brendan.
I would
think Mike would be good. Mike Fleischauer.
Mike does sound okay. I'm not going with Mike. I'm going to go with
Ryan Fleischauer.
James
Fleischauer.
No, I was just thinking of my uncle's name. It's tough to find something to match with Fleischauer, dude. I'm surprised that this last name has made it this long. I guess.
But like your dad and your uncle, those are just simple names. Like
Brad and Sam. I guess so. Maybe Mike and like a. Yeah, I guess you're right, dude. Like a simple name, it would have to be like a Mike and maybe a. Let's think of a girl name. Blue Ivy. God,
Blue Ivy.
Looking at. Brandy,
South
maybe. Maybe Brand. Saul Goodman.
Suck.
Nah, Brandy sounds okay with Brandy. Fly Shower. I guess maybe if I had a girl, like if I had to just think of a name on the spot, which I would hope I never had to do, I'll roll with that.
Would you ever change your last name if they gave you an opportunity?
Nah, dude, no way.
You like it?
I do. I think it's weird, and I hate having to like deal with people pronouncing it to me, and they're like, "How do you say that? What is that?" But I mean, it's cool. Whatever. People remember it. You know, they see it and they remember it. So.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Where are we at? If you only had one album to listen to for the rest of your life, which album would it be?
An album. Maybe that Kendrick album, or I'm trying to think of just the best albums recently that have came out. It'd be tough to listen to one album, dude. Just over and over. Maybe Zero Gravity Part 2, man. That one's awesome by Los now. But
is that the
I guess me, dude. Me, yeah. I would pick like a Los album for sure. Like him. You know, maybe like a Keith Urban Greatest Hits, too.
Mm-hmm.
Would be a good one. I'd pick either like a Los or a Keith Urban Greatest Hits.
Okay. You have endless amount of something, not money. What would it be?
Endless amount of... Damn, these are good, dude. This is good, man. Endless amount... I'm trying to think of something that would... An endless amount of... Maybe... I'm trying to think of something that would save me money. Like, if it's not going to have to... If it's not money, what would... Maybe, like, gas? An endless amount of gasoline would be awesome.
I didn't even think about that, but that would
be... That's actually for sure gasoline.
Endless amount of gasoline.
That's a good one.
That's a great answer. Bringing it today, man.
Bringing it. I've nailed a few of these. I've struggled with some of them, but...
Okay, you own a sports team. What is the team name and what is a mascot?
The team name... Let's see. I would roll with probably...
And you can pick your city.
Okay, well, I'll roll with Lubbock then, just because if Lubbock were ever big enough, you would want to do it in your own hometown, right?
And I guess what sport would it be too?
I would like NFL because NFL is my favorite sport. So, and I would want the team name to be Lone Stars. I mean, that's our team name, Lone Stars. Lubbock Lone Stars. They had that team though. Damn it,
yeah,
that was
they
a
did.
Team, huh?
Gimmick infringement. Yeah.
Yeah. Damn it. Okay, so not Lone Stars, obviously. I mean, yeah, you can say, I'm not stealing that from them. Yeah, I am, kind of, huh? Lubbock Lone Stars, I guess that is kind of stealing.
Yeah, no team has really stolen something from people. Really.
Yeah. Okay. I feel like our team name's not, like, can you think of one right now? Let me put you on the spot.
Okay, so if I own a sports team, what would the team name be?
Yeah.
I would say the Diablos. I kind of like the Diablos.
That's
maybe
a
not even just
one.
Lubbock, but like the Texas Diablos.
Okay.
Or something like that. I don't know. And then
what
like,
sport? Baseball?
I would go with MLS, dude.
Yeah, see, I was going to say MLS,
I think that's
too.
A little safer than an NFL team or something like that, NBA team.
Yeah.
Maybe like a
Austin Lone Stars MLS team or something.
Okay, yeah, that could possibly work. The Diablos, and the mascot would be a little devil with pitchfork. With a mustache.
did you ask if I would have a mascot, what the mascot would be?
Yeah, what would the mascot be?
I'm going to stick with Lone Star just because I like that name.
Okay, what would your mascot be?
It would be...
Not a star, Jesus Christ.
It would be a star.
Star
no,
David.
Got me. God dang, that's funny. Let's see. It would probably be like, I mean, a Lone Star, like you would just, like a dude,
like a Texas Ranger,
like a gun, kind of, like a Ranger or something, yeah. I guess these ideas are kind of taken by Texas teams, though. Like,
yeah,
if you think about
Rangers,
the Rangers, the... You know, the
flag of the Lone Star. You got one Lone Star flag.
One tech, the guns up. You know, like, that's... They got the guy with the guns walking around. That's what I just said.
Yeah.
So, yeah. That's a tough one, dude.
Okay. What is the one word that describes your bedroom?
Hairy. No, I'm kidding, dude. My dog does shed a lot in there, though, and it's gross. I have to vacuum, like, once, like, every 3 days. But,
yeah.
Nah, my room is, I feel like it's kind of cluttered. It's not like a mess, really. It's just like there's a bunch of stuff. You know, living at home still, you have a bunch of stuff that, like, when you move out, you won't take with you.
Mm-hmm.
And so, probably kind of like cluttered. There's a bunch of stuff in there I don't really need anymore that's just built up over the years, you know. What would you say about yours, Texas Tech Red Raiders?
I would say clean. I think for a 22-year-old kid, I think
every
I'm
time
clean.
I come over here, it's pretty damn clean, dude.
And my bed's
always
made. You know,
is that like OCD, or you just do it?
It's just habit.
Yeah.
Every morning when my parents wake me up, it's make your bed. And it's just,
that's good, dude.
And I like my bed made. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't want to see sheets. And,
yeah, see, my bed looks like shit usually.
So, yeah, that clean, you know, to an extent, organized. I mean, Everything looks pretty organized. Shoes are in one spot. Games are in one spot, you know?
Yeah.
What is your favorite picture that you have in your house?
I've got this one thing. Like, it's not one picture, but it's like a thing that someone got me for Christmas where it's just, it's like a big frame that's like, it's got a bunch of different pictures, like in a collage, where mm-hmm. it's got like pictures of me when I was a kid, you know, with my parents, then with like my first dog that I bought, and then, or not that I bought, but that was given to me when I was a kid. And like, it's got the picture of me with Donald Driver in it. Yeah. It's got a picture of my dog. Probably just that big frame. I don't know. There's not one picture. If I had to pick one picture, it'd probably be the one of me with Donald Driver.
Okay, yeah. Donald Driver. Is that the most famous person you've met?
Yeah, for okay. sure. Because everyone knows him. Or, I mean, most people. Not everyone knows him, but a lot of people.
If you were invisible for a day, would you grab more butts or more tits?
Ooh. Probably more asses, because I think that's more of an, no pun intended, asset to a woman than tits are.
Okay.
You get me? You feel what I'm saying?
I
would you go grab tits?
Yeah, you know, I think...
Damn, that'd be tough, dude. I'd really grab both.
I'm a tit guy. I just think everybody has an ass, you know?
Yeah. Everyone does, but not everyone does, technically. But
okay, yeah.
I mean, everyone does.
I mean, I have an ass, you know? Yeah, you have an ass.
I do,
I mean,
but you,
we don't have tits.
No, we don't. That's true. Yeah, I mean, I get what you're saying there, because it's you're grabbing, okay, that makes sense.
All right, let's go back up to something we missed.
All right.
Who do you owe an apology to?
I owe an apology to...
If you don't have to name names, you can just... A friend, a relative, just...
Friend. Oh, God, dude. That is a tough one, dude. I know that there's someone that I need to be like, yo, my B. And this can go back to any. See, I don't have.
You don't hold grudges on people.
Yeah, and I would hope people don't hold them on me. So, but maybe okay. There was someone I. This is all I can think of, dude. And I feel like I should say sorry for this because it was rude. I commented on a Bleacher Report article. Someone was talking shit about Julius Peppers to the Packers, and I said, F off, pussy. So I felt bad for that, and I tried, and you know, maybe that's all I can think of, dude. I owe that person an apology, I believe. So my bad.
Right.
My bad.
Okay,
you can't just go around dropping P-bombs on everyone. You know what I mean? A P-bomb? You can't be just...
No.
Pussy?
No, you really...
You can't just...
You really can't. Brendan, I think we're going to wrap up here in a little bit. That was, we went through those pretty quick.
Yeah.
But that's cool. That's cool. I mean, did you have a good time?
Was that fun? Yeah, they were tough questions, dude. I feel like, I don't know, I probably only answered about, how many were there?
There was about...
Was there 40?
About 40.
See, I probably answered probably about 30 of them. 25 of them good.
Yeah.
The rest were kind of, it's tough to think of answers off the top of your
head. Here's another one. Have you ever been in rehab or AA?
No.
No.
Good okay. thing I have it. Good thing. I don't plan to be there anytime soon, but yeah. You never know.
Okay.
Just kidding. Yeah, I don't plan on that.
Let's see. Let's go ahead and plug your Twitter real quick before we get on out of here. We have one more question left, but let's plug your Twitter.
All right. I got @flyshower11.
On the Twitter.
Don't even spell
no,
that.
No, again. You're good. I think people can find me on Twitter then. And then, go to friends, I guess, and,
true.
And look at that. But
I'm findable.
Before we get out of here, Brendan, we've been doing this for about 50 episodes, and you've been there since day one.
Absolutely, man.
I can't believe it's gone 50. You know,
it's crazy.
We're working towards 52, and I'm not going to stop anytime soon. But you actually named the podcast. And I remember we were sitting in the sub.
I do remember that.
And I just said, hey, Brendan, I want to start a podcast. And you were like, do it, man. Do it. And you've been here for a majority of the shows, a lot of the shows. So
yes,
so I thank you a lot, man. I
yes,
appreciate
sir.
That.
Show, man.
So I got you something, a little something.
Oh, goodness.
It's not big. It's not much. Just a little something. Appreciation for being here.
Yes, sir.
And enjoying this podcast with me, this thing.
Oh, hell yeah, dude.
There's one more thing in there.
All right. What do we got here? Oh, hell yeah, dude. You can't go wrong getting me some Green Bay stuff, bro. I appreciate it, man.
It's a Green Bay shot glass with the Green Bay koozie.
Hell yeah.
So, yeah, thank you for being here.
No doubt, man. It's fun to be here.
And still wanting to be part of this podcast, this adventure that I'm going through.
Yeah, it's fun, dude.
All right, so before we start crying and get all emotional,
oh my God, there's the tissues.
we'll get on out of here with the final question. If you get the script, and thank you for coming on again,
mm-hmm.
and we'll probably see you next week. Next week will be a regular show.
Absolutely.
If you could script the last words of your life, what would they be?
The last words. What did my dad say, dude? What did my dad was at a phone? No, I'm not. I don't even want to go back to that. I would just say, God dang it, I'm gonna go back to what I've been like. All my answers have been, go Pack, go. Little Hank, little Drake, a little something bumping, thump thumping on the wheel ride. The mix in our drink's a little stronger than you think, so get a grip, take a sip of that feel ride. Truck's jacked up, flat bills flip back. Yeah, you can find us where the party's at. This is how we